Hello student, myself Professor Gada Keses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yola. Student, we are learning the final year subject, that is the solar and wind energy. So from that subject up to the last lecture, from unit number 1 to 4, we have discussed all the points. And also from some last lecture, we have started the unit number 5, that is nothing but the wind energy. So related to that unit number 5, we have discussed some topics that are nothing but basics of wind energy, that means how the wind is generated and how with the help of wind we can use that wind for the mechanical power or electrical power output. Then principle of wind energy conversion we have seen, that means how wind energy is converted into the mechanical energy or electrical power. Then we have seen basic components of the wind energy conversion system. So how that wind energy get converted into the mechanical or electrical power, that we have seen. Then we have seen types of wind energy. Three types of wind energy we have seen. So those who have not seen that video, you can see that video. Then types of wind mill we have seen. So two types of wind mills are there, horizontal wind mill and vertical wind mill. So as per the name, horizontal and vertical, that means based on the position of the shaft of the rotor, horizontal and vertical wind mills are there. Now in the today's lecture, we are going to see the next point, that is the site selection consideration for the wind power plants. So that is the important point, that is nothing but the site selection consideration. That means you cannot install the wind power plant at any location as per your requirement. So you have to check some parameters. Based on that parameters, if that parameters are satisfied, you can install the power plant for the particular reason. So let's see which are the consideration for the site selection of the wind power plant. So for first consideration is that the best location to place the wind turbine are the top of the rounded hills. That means best location is nothing but the rounded hills where the airflow is in the large quantity. So that is the best location for producing or installing the wind power plant or wind turbine. On open plains and mountain passes where wind is naturally funneled through the producing regular high wind speed. That means where the speed of the wind is larger as compared to the other region. So at that location you can install the wind power plant easily. That means the main consideration is that you have to check the availability of the airflow or speed of the air you have to check. Generally, the higher the elevation, the better, since higher elevation usually have the more wind. That means higher elevation is better. Why it is better? Because it has a more wind flow. Because we know at the topmost side or at the bottom, as compared to the bottom, there will be the more air flow on the higher side. So two consideration are there. First one, you have to check the availability of the wind flow, and second one, you have to check that the position should be at the top, not on the ground. So that's are the two conditions. Now next consideration we have to consider, that is nothing but the wind energy forecasting is an important tool for setting a wind turbine. That means you should forecast the wind speed or related to the wind various data you should be forecast, then and then your wind power plant will work efficiently. So that forecasting will important point in the selection consideration, site selection consideration for wind power plant. There are variety of wind speed maps and data from the National Ocean and Atmospheric Administration, that is NOAA, or National Renewable Energy Laboratory, NREL, in the US, that provided this data. That means you should able to receive the forecast about the wind, such position you can able to install the wind turbine or wind power plant. Next consideration related to the site selection of the wind power plant is nothing but the site specific survey should be done to assess the local wind condition and to determine the best direction to place the wind turbine for maximum efficiency. That means you should have to check the direction of the flow in which the wind flows maximum rate. So your efficiency will be maximum. So for at least a year, project on a land tracks wind speed, turbulence and direction, as well as air temperature and humidity also. If temperature or humidity differs, then and then will be efficiency will be decreased for the turbines. Once that information is determined, turbine that will delivers predictable result can be built. That means predictable result can be built when you consider all the consideration. Then next consideration is that wind isn't only factors for setting the turbines. Developer for a wind farm must consider how close the farm is to the transmission lines. So that means you should also consider, you have to also consider that the transport charges for the light, generated light, should not be larger also. That you have to consider also. So that is the point, that developer have to wind farm must consider how close the farm is to the transmission line. Possible interference to the local airport and the plane tariffs, underlying rocks and the faults, flight patterns of the birds and the bats, and local community impacts, that is the noise and other possible effects. That all point you have to consider while selecting the site for the wind power plant. One last point you have to consider for selecting the site for the power plant is nothing but the most larger wind projects are designed to last at least 20 years, if not more. So these factors must be considered over the long terms. That means you have to consider that you have to set up the wind power plant for at least 20 years. Okay, if you are not set up that for 20 years, your installation cost will be unuseful and you will go in the loss. So if you want to recover that all the cost, you have to set up the wind power plant for the 20 years at least. More than that, you can use, no problem. So such a factors are there which you have to consider while selecting the site for the wind power plants. So in short, what you have to consider, you have to consider that the airflow, availability of airflow. Second point you have to consider that is your turbine should be at higher level, not should be at the bottom level. Third point you have to consider that you should receive the forecasting about the winds easily. Fourth point you have to consider that the conditions of the years is changing or not, that you have to consider. Then next point you have to consider that wind isn't only forecast for the sitting turbine. That means developer have to consider that the transmission of the generated electricity should not be for greater lines. All of you understand that. And the last point you have to consider that the deserve or setup plant should be run for at least 20 years or more than 20 years, no problem. So that's are some factors which we have to consider while selecting the site. If you don't consider such factors, your plant will not going to efficiently work, and obviously the owner should get the, or a developer should get the loss. But to bring it into the profit and good plants, you have to consider that all points while selecting the sites for the wind power plant. So today we will stop here for the today's lecture. Next point we will continue in the next lecture.